guys, it's Just the Tip Tuesday, so I want to share with you a way to be able to get more deals. Now, 60% of all my deals, as I've written before, comes through resubmittals or reoffering. So for instance, I went out there one time and I made an offer on a property for $145,000. Well, somebody made an offer on that property for $160,000 and I didn't get the deal. That deal fell out of escrow, so I resubmitted again. Then the offer came in from another party for the same property for $165,000. I went, I submitted my $145,000 offer, I didn't get the deal again. Third time, somebody went and offered $170,000 for the property. I offered my $145,000 because that's where the numbers work for this particular project. I resubmitted again, and guess what? The offer deal fell through again. So here it is, literally 6 months later, the third offer falls through. The bank calls and contacts me and says, listen, we've had three offers fall out. Would you consider taking this deal? And I said, sure, for $145,000. And they sold me the property for $145,000 and I got the deal. Now, guess what? 6 months later, when that deal came through, it felt like it was the perfect time. It felt like it was the perfect time and I got that deal. It just seemed to fall in place. But that deal came through a resubmittal. So how are you going to be able to get more resubmittals, more offers, and more deals coming through? One of the things that I always do, number one, is I always keep a record of every offer that I make. Number two, I resubmit my offers, or I resubmit those offers every 30 days. So here's how I do it. In the old school days, before we had all this great electronic filing, all this electronic filing systems that we have nowadays, I would go and I would make my offer in a green folder. And I would literally put one on the folder. Just put one of those little sticky things on it, or one of those little plastic file folder holders, and it said one. And I make all my offers for that day in folder number one. I'd have folder 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, all the way to 30, and I'd have literally a hanging fire folder case. Well, let's say that it's the 14th of the month. I go out, I look at new properties, I make new offers today, but I also reach in my file folder, and I would look at those properties and see which one of those properties had not been submitted, or excuse me, had not been accepted. So if it was not sold, if it was still active or still pending, or if it was a BOM back on the market, everything on the 14th of that month, I would resubmit along with my new offers. I do the same thing on the 15th. Any new properties that I looked at, I'd submit offers on the 15th, and I pull out my folder to the 15th, and I would resubmit on those offers. Now, here's what would happen. I would keep those offers, and once I got it accepted, I'd move those offers over to, let's say, my blue folder. Those are my accepted offers. If they got sold, then I would just literally go and I would move those to a red folder called sold offers. Now, why didn't I just throw those out? I'll tell you why in just a second with them. So I would go and I would resubmit on all these offers every day. So what happened is, after about 2 or 3 months, I was able to hit critical mass where I was making tons of offers every day, because I was not only going and submitting the few offers that I had looked at today, but also going back and resubmitting everything on the 14th from 1, 2, 3 months ago. So I would literally be turning 20, 25 offers in a day over a period of time, and I would go and see offers come through constantly and consistently. Then I keep that red folder. I would go back and look at that red folder, and I see what I offered versus what the houses were sold for. And if I felt like there was still profit in some of those houses, but somebody offered a little bit more, I would go learn about what was acceptable in that area and what banks or owners were accepting for offers in that area. And all it did was give me a little bit more knowledge about where I failed, because it's okay to fail. We have a saying in our company, fail and fail well, fail and fail fast. So it would tell me what's going on about where I missed it in those particular areas, so I could learn about how to make adjustments in my offers and for my properties. So let's go back. Follow up on your offers. Make sure you're making offers almost every day, if not every day if possible. Put folders together, whether they're electronic or paper folders. Go back and check your offers every 30 days. And if they are not sold, if they are still active, pending, or BOMs back on the markets, resubmit on them. I would even resubmit on pending offers. I don't even care if the bank says we're not accepting offers or backup offers. I'd resubmit anyways, because I want the bank to know that I'm serious about this and they have a serious buyer with them on their side who will go and fulfill, because I'm always following up. Because here's what the thing the banks know. Most people fall out. Most people don't follow up. Most people don't take not only immediate action, but consistent action. So the banks will go and they'll look at, hey, listen, here's this guy Armando, he's got this company and they're always making offers and they keep offering on this project and we've taken some higher offers and these offers have fallen out of place. He's making the same offer. Maybe his offer is right. Maybe he actually has the pricing right. we as a bank have the offer wrong, or all of our competitors, my competitors, or all the other people who are offering higher prices have it wrong. That's why these deals keep falling out of place, because they're offering too much money. All right, guys, this has been Just the Tip Tuesday. Make sure you leave me a comment right here on the blog post. Don't go leave it on some other social media forum, right here on the blog post, so I can try to get back and answer some of your comments quickly. Make sure that you have an awesome, amazing day. Take care, and we'll talk to you soon.